Glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Explosive plays, that's a catchphrase for coaches all over the country, and both of these teams are certainly capable of getting them in bunches. They love to throw the football down the field, so you better buckle up, and the secondaries better buckle those chin straps. They're in for a long day. That's going to do it for us. Thanks for checking out the pregame show. NCAA college football action coming right at you. Brad and Kirk on the call. David and I are back at halftime.
Notre Dame Stadium is the site for this one.
And now let's head down to the coin toss. Brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything.
Benjamin is on the field to kick this one off, and everyone in the stadium is ready for this game to get started. Brown fields it at the 2, got the corner, at the 30. He steps out to 37-yard line. Virginia Tech staff and their fans have heard all week long their quarterback's going to play terribly on the road. I think their staff's got them ready to prove them wrong right now.
I think this staff really has rallied this entire team around some of that negative talk. And I think they believe in their guy that he can go on the road and make the plays and lead them to a big victory. You know, sometimes when you hit some adversity like that, you see teams circle the wagons. And I really believe this week they've done a great job of doing that. Now they just have to go out and execute the plan and go out and win this game.
From the 48-yard line, first down. And he's hit immediately.
I tell you what, this defense better start to get pressure on the quarterback. They're giving him way too much time back there to throw the football.
From the 30-yard line, it's first down. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun.
Easy, easy, easy. Lock in.
Gets it out quickly, and he's tackled at the 25-yard line. 5 yards.
This is good timing here between the quarterback and the wide receiver. Recognizing the soft coverage from the defensive back, the quarterback puts the ball right in the money for a nice game.
Wants to throw outside.
Virginia Tech's got a guy that statistically is leading the conference right now, and he has got the attention of everybody in the country, including the coordinators.
From the 25-yard line, it's third down. Quickly to the tailback. He's taken down around the 20-yard line.
Well, it was third down, so they obviously had to get to the sticks, and they did just that with this little pass play.
Five wide. And they get nice yardage on that run.
That brings him second and five.
It's second and five here. Ball on the 15-yard line.
Let's go, let's go. Mike, 53.
The 10, and they make the stop
around the 6-yard line.
So he keeps it, and he gets a big first down.
The quarterback made a very good decision here not to pitch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big game.
And this play is number 8 on the drive.
And he's tackled after positive yardage.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That brings up second and goal.
That brings up a second and goal. About a yard to Pater. This defense not wanting to give an inch here. And he's taken down at the 4-yard line.
Well, that's just a good call from the defensive side of the football. They know what this team likes to run, and they got the better of them that time.
Here's play number 10 on the drive. Right around the 4-yard line. Maybe a yard on the run by the tailback. It's fourth down. This isn't much more than an extra point. Virginia Tech is looking to go up by 3. The kick is up, and he got it. Let's get the latest now from Reese Davis.
Let's take a look at some action in the Big 12. High-powered offenses everywhere. And for UTEP, they've now won 3 in a row.
All right, thanks, Reese. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Hart from the 2. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Makes the first down catch. Tackle made at the 36. The 45.
The quarterback and his receiver make a great play here and convert on an early down.
On the ground, inside. Nice run, and he's brought down. And he carried that one for a few yards.
You know, when you have a guy that can grab 5 yards or so consistently, it sure takes some of the pressure off the passing game.
Man can't tack on any yardage. He's tackled at the 27-yard line. Field tackle.
That makes it second and 10.
From the 27-yard line, second down. He throws. Still perfect on the drive.
This guy just continues to impress me. Every time I watch this team play, he seems to come up with big plays.
And the secondary didn't quite seem alert enough to defend that pass. He splits the uprights with the extra point. A 7-play, 81-yard drive. And the result, 7 points.
Brad, I love these kind of drives. They're old school, grind it out and earn the yards and just rip the heart right out of that defense.
So the score now, 7-3. Brown from the 5. And he's hammered down. And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Carter gained 7 yards on that play.
That'll make it second and 4.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. And he carries the ball for a nice game. Both offenses trying to find their rhythm in that first quarter. Low scoring and close right now. Notre Dame's up by 4. And we're back for more action here in quarter number 2. Fires out to his receiver. And down he goes around the 34-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 34. Fires incomplete, knocked away.
Hey, that's a heads-up play there by the defender. Get those hands up and something good may just happen.
They spread the field in the gun with 5 wide receivers. Deep pass to the end zone. And he scores! Touchdown! Trying to go up by 3, they'll kick the extra point. And he hits the PAT. A 5-play, 76-yard drive, and they get it in for 7.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Caught at the 8. Down the sideline. Brought down at the 50.
Well, this is a very competitive game. Just when you think one team has gained the advantage or the momentum, the other team comes fighting back, and it's going back and forth. This is almost like a basketball game.
There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Brought down at the 40-yard line. Great tackle at the 46.
Boy, Brad, that was a big hit on the quarterback. You'd be interested to see how he responds from this hit and whether or not he comes after his offensive lineman and challenges them to start playing a little bit better.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 40. The offense going to try to open this field up, coming out in a 5-wide set, and the defense counters with their dime look. He's level at the 38. There are 5 wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. And he's tackled at the 28. Sub package in there defensively in this 5 wide receiver set. He's hit and taken down. What a play, and that is first and goal. Come out in a 5-wide set. End zone picked off.
interception.
This safety always seems to be in the right place at the right time. It's no surprise that he comes up with the interception here.
From their own 11-yard line, first down. Virginia Tech is up by three. Tackled after a decent run up the gut.
That'll make it second and four.
He makes it to the 18-yard line. They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. Five wide receivers in the formation. Caught and out of bounds after a short gain. It out to about the 36. From their own 36-yard line, first down. And he is drilled at the 46-yard line.
I think it was a great play call, and it was very well executed. Any coach would be happy with that kind of outcome on a first or second down play.
Wants it all, going long. Oh, what an interception.
This quarterback better start making better decisions in the passing game. Otherwise, this corner will come up with even more picks in the future.
They'll line up at the 11. It's first down. Gets it out quickly to the back, but he can't haul it in.
That makes it second and ten.
And he throws it away. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Third and 10 coming up. Ball on the 11. He fights forward to about the 13. Russell picks up 2 yards with a carry. Virginia Tech's going to have to use their second timeout of the half. Barber is the punter. Brown takes it at the 47. He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line. The Hokies, over the years, have had great quarterbacks. They've got another one. He's proving to be that here in the first half, and he's the true leader of this group right now.
Leadership. You hit the nail right on the head. This team is moving the football, but it has everything to do with this young man and what he's been able to do for them. Because, he's making great throws. He's making good checks at the line of scrimmage. But the thing that's standing out to me is his leadership and the way this team responds to that leadership. And that's why this team right now has played as well as they have.
From the 36-yard line, it's second down. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with 5 wideouts. He's at the 20, and he's tackled right away.
That makes it first and 10.
First and 10. Ball on the 16-yard line. Virginia Tech is up a field goal. And he's hit immediately.
up second and one.
Easy. Stingray! Stingray!
Get to that quickly.
Gaining 4 yards. That makes it first and goal.
Easy. Fox two.
Offense lines up in a 5-wide set, and a defense anticipating pass here.
Fires quickly. Touchdown.
Converts the extra point. So a 5-play, 36-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
This quarterback has really demonstrated a tremendous amount of ability and leadership today. I'd be very surprised if he didn't continue to play well.
So our score, 17-7.
Johnson from the three, and he's taken down at the 22-yard line.
The offense takes the field again. They were forced to punt their last time out.
From
their own 22-yard line. Second down.
Tackle at the 34.
And the delayed handoff works for a big gain.
Got to be happy with the effort there by your tailback.
Notre Dame's going to use their first time out of the half here.
He's under some heat.
He's wrapped up for the sack. And for Morris, that was his second sack of the game.
When you talk about a dominant lineman, this is the kind of guy you're talking about. He's got 2 sacks today. He can bring constant pressure. Really just a nightmare for the big boys up front.
Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation. As they head to the locker rooms, this one is far from over. 17-7, Hokies.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Keith Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. This team's now got a hill to climb in the second half. We anticipated it being a tight game, but as you watch this team late in the half, you started to see guys looking for answers. You could almost sense it. They were looking at who's going to take ownership, who's going to lead and make a play. Somebody has to step up right now, Dave.
Yeah, no doubt about it. When you come into games, you feel like you have this huge game plan and all this stuff you want to accomplish, and sometimes it doesn't work. And sometimes you got to start changing things around, and sometimes it's simple. Sometimes the quarterback needs to come in the huddle and say, hey, guys, y'all want to protect me a little better? You know, they need to say some things that makes people feel uncomfortable sometimes to get a rise at them and knowing your team. Sometimes middle linebackers have to get the defense all in tight and say, listen, you need to make sure you're taking care of this. They've been killing us on this route. It's your fault. Step up. The leaders in the huddle a lot of times can say the things that the coaches can't and get a different reaction.
Well, maybe it's time I say something to you, too. It's time for you to pick up your game at halftime. That's going to do it at halftime, just about ready to start the second half.
All right, you finish it up, bro. I'm going to get something in the cafeteria. I'm hungry.
Wait, don't leave until you get my order. Brad Kirk, take the second half.
All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here.
He'll take it from the 2. They'll bring him down at the 25.
Virginia Tech's continuing to play extremely tough defense. This has been impressive.
It's just been impressive to watch them play with such an attitude, almost a chip on their shoulder with the energy that they're playing with. And I think it's going to require that kind of effort to be able to win this game.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game.
He goes out of bounds
at about the 29-yard line.
That'll make it second and 7.
Check 54.
Pitches back. He's out of bounds at the 35-yard line. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 35. Tight end, and they make the stop at about the 43-yard line.
That brings in second and nine.
He's at the 30. He's at the 20. He gets hit out of bounds
around the 11-yard line.
So with that run, they pick up another first.
Just a nice job again up front by the offensive line. They're doing a good job of neutralizing the defensive front, and it's allowed them to move the ball down the field.
They need to find a way to get points this trip in the red zone.
He gets out to about the 9-yard line.
Gain of 2 yards. That brings up second and nine.
Gets to about the 8-yard line.
Gain of 1 on the play. That makes it 3rd and 7.
And once again, they'll come to the line trying to convert on 3rd down.
Pass complete and taken down immediately. They can make this a one-possession game with this kick right here. It's up, and it is good. Notre Dame gets set to kick this one away. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 30-yard line. It's a new possession for this offense, so what will it hold? Virginia Tech up 7 points. A 1-yard gain by the halfback.
This linebacker's had a couple of years of experience, and he's really solidified himself as a reliable tackler, as you can see from that last stop.
We've got a 2nd and 9 here. Ball on the 31.
Got it on the quick throw, and he's taken down at the 32. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. Zipped it out, and that was almost picked off. Bray was the intended receiver on that pass, and that'll make it 4th down.
On 3rd down, the defense was expecting the pass, and they defended the play very well in the secondary.
Tackle at the 48-yard line. Virginia Tech's coaches just got to be happy. I'd love to coach a kid like this.
Oh, I think these coaches love to coach a guy like this, and another great performance by him individually and for this offense.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete.
Richardson was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
From their own 48-yard line, it's second down. Strike to his receiver, no good.
As a defender, you want to keep your hands up. Maybe you can come away with a pick or at least deflect the ball.
Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. Tackle made around the 43-yard line.
That makes it fourth and inches.
It's fourth down, and they're going to try to go for it. He's taken down at about the 45, and the defense comes through.
This time the offense isn't successful on fourth down. The defense had that option play snuffed out from the get-go.
Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. Virginia Tech is up by a touchdown. Nice pitch and catch for the first down. It's first and 10. Ball on the 43-yard line. Nice run there. Carter comes away with around 5 yards on the delayed handoff.
That makes it second and 6.
Too little, cut. Hey, right 52, right 52. Here we go.
He makes it to the 35-yard line. So they pick up 3 on the option keeper. It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Nice run up the middle.
Gaining 5 yards. First down.
Out of bounds around the 26-yard line. We head to the final quarter, and we've got a great game on our hands. 17-10, Hokie. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter. Virginia Tech is up 7. Knocked out of bounds at the 25-yard line. Back to the line, maybe a yard on the pass.
That's a nice completion, but give the defense a lot of credit. They weren't fooled at all. They were able to hold him to a short game.
So we're looking at another third down here. He's got his man across the middle. Brought down at the 12.
I like the call here by the defense to bring the heat with the outside linebacker. It was just a better call by the offense, and that's why it's a first down.
And this is the 8th play of the drive. And he's tackled at the 14.
That'll bring up second and 12.
From the 14-yard line, second down.
The defense got a great push and blew that play up well behind the line of scrimmage.
And this is the 10th play of the drive.
Let's go.
10-yard line. This one should be makeable. Kicks up, and it splits the uprights. Andy has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off. Hart takes from the 10. And he makes it out to about the 27-yard line. And the defense made a big stop on fourth down the last time this offense was out there.
Let's see if this offense can reestablish some confidence after being stopped on downs the last time they were out on the field.
Throws quickly, and it's almost intercepted.
Picks was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on their own 27. It in as he's pushed out of bounds. With the pass incomplete.
The intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
From their own 38-yard line, it's second down.
That's just how they drew it up. When I talked to this coach earlier in the week, he thought he could take advantage of zone coverage by attacking the perimeter outside the hashes. That time, it was a corner route, and it got him the first down.
He's got it with room to run. And down he goes, right around the 36-yard line. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. Tackle around the 19-yard line. Just under three to go in regulation. Big play there, and now they're looking at first and goal. To him again, complete. He's gobbled up in the backfield.
Morris brings him down at the 4-yard line. That brings up second and goal.
Fires quickly. Touchdown.
This entire group functions so well as a unit, and you saw it on that touchdown. Very good team effort.
The draw within a field goal. And he tacks on the extra point. So a 9-play, 72-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brett, I thought the key to that drive really had a lot to do with the quarterback and the receivers getting in sync, making it very tough for the defense to slow him down.
He just drills this one. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. A quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers. Quick throw out to the receiver. They'll bring him down at the 35. Notre Dame's going to take their first time out of the half.
You know what? After a play like that, I wouldn't be the least bit surprised if they went to the air again.
So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down. And he's hit before he can go anywhere. First down there on a 5-yard pass.
And I like the decision the quarterback made on this play. He didn't try to force a deep pass. Instead, he just threw a little dump-off pass that was good enough for a first down.
A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Quick throw, and he's tackled right away.
That's pretty impressive. Accuracy is important, but just as important is having receivers that can make plays.
First and 10, ball on the 48. He's tackled right around the 20. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 20. Guns it across the middle. Throws quickly into the end zone. Caught for the touchdown. The Hokies knew they had a star quarterback. He came through for them in the clutch.
And this defense knows how good this quarterback is. In fact, that's why they decided to try to get as much pressure on him as they could. They weren't able to get home, leaving him plenty of time to make the throw, and he delivered when he needed to.
He makes the PAT. Let's get the latest now from Reese Davis.
Let's check in and see what's happening in Miami. The Golden Panthers, they draw first blood through the air going up top for six. FIU leads it 7-0. Elsewhere, let's get you up to date on what's happening in Houston. And for Houston, they strike with the first touchdown of the game. Houston has the edge 7-0.
And we thank you, Reese Davis. Virginia back to the action here. Virginia Tech ready to kick this one off. He'll return it from the six. And down he goes at the 34. This offense just torched the defense through the air with a great passing attack on their last drive.
This quarterback right now is in a rhythm, and a lot of that has to do with his preparation. You can see right now with the reads that he's being able to make, getting the football out of his hands, that he's feeling very, very confident in his ability to throw the football against this defense.
Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. He wants it all, going long. Almost intercepted. From their own 49-yard line, second down. Wants it all, going deep. Throws, and he's got a man. Touchdown. Here's the extra point to draw within 3 points. He splits the uprights with the extra point. So a short three-play, 66-yard drive, and they get it in for seven. So our score, 27-24. Taken down at the 39-yard line. Wow, what a fourth quarter, Kirk. Both these teams are scoring at will.
Can either one of these defenses come up with a stop? Just make a play. Otherwise, it's going to come down to who has the ball left.
So not a lot of time left, and they've got an opportunity right now, if they score, to put the nail in the coffin in this game. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. From the 42-yard line, second down. Runs in, and he's stopped short of the line of scrimmage.
Virginia Tech staff just dancing on the sideline. Their star player came through for them, and they couldn't be happier.
Well, the staff has to feel good. The entire team should feel good. And I know you and I just having a chance to sit back and watch this young man play. Just an outstanding performance and something that this entire team will be able to build on.
That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.